Srirangapatna is an island formed by River Kaveri and is located at a distance of 13 km from Mysore and 127 km from Bangalore. Kaveri River splits into two streams and surrounds Srirangapatna and then confluence again. This point of confluence is one of the famous spots called Kaveri Sangama. Srirangnath Swami Temple. This Dravidian style temple was built in 9th century under the reign of Gangas. The inner structure was mostly built during Hoysala reign. The damages caused due to time was later restored by the Mysore kings. There are three temples of Ranganatha Swami which are considered to be very auspicious. Adiranga, which is situated here in Srirangapatna, Madhyaranga is in Shivanasamudra and Antyaranga in Srirangam, Tamil Nadu. 24 pillars stand inside this temple. Each depicts an avatar, incarnation of Vishnu. In the Garbhagriha of the temple, an idol of Vishnu sleeping on Adishesha is worshipped. Lakshadipotsava, held during every Sankranti, is very popular and attracts lakhs of pilgrims. Jamia Masjid. This mosque was built by Tipu Sultan during 1786-87. Jamia Masjid is well known for its beauty. The minars stand tall and attracts a lot of attention from the visitors. The wall and the roof are decorated with a lot of pictures and adds to the beauty of this place. Jamia Masjid has a siren white tomb, a prayer hall and a wide open space within the walls. These walls are carved with 99 different names of Allah. The piece of article that caught our eyes is the massive antique clock that hangs here and still works as good as new. Jamia Masjid is towards the Bangalore gate of the fort. It is believed that this fort was built in 1454 when Vijayanagara Empire Timmanna Nayaka was on the throne. Train journeys are always memorable, and if you have ever travelled the Bangalore-Mysore stretch, this railway bridge in Srirangapatna is sure to be etched in your memory. This massive structure is built with very sturdy iron and steel material. The bridge is built on the Kaveri River and an ideal hangout spot, but safety measures are to be kept in mind. Next to this bridge was a 225-year-old armory of Tipu Sultan, which has now been translocated to make way for a railway track between Mysore and Bengaluru. this place where Tipu stored his arms, ammunition and weapons, including rockets and missiles during his 17-year reign. Srirangapatna. The island town of Srirangapatna got its name from the Ranganatha temple built in 9th century. The Indo-Muslim style of architecture can be clearly seen in Darya Daulat Bagh and Jamia Masjid. Srirangapatna held an important role in Mysore Empire and was also the capital during Tipu's rule. The Obelisk. Tipu's capital was invaded by East Indian Company and seized by the soldiers during the 4th Anglo-Mysore War. Obelisk in Srirangapatna is a memorial erected by then government of Mysore in memory of the English soldier died during the siege of Srirangapatna. The obelisk stands at the center of an expansive and concentric series of steps, on a high point close to the front walls. The four palaks fixed on the square base is incredible, with various details. A war memorial commemorating the victory of the British over Tipu Sultan. Above the base structure is a colonial projection supported by four cannonballs. Another cannonball is fixed at the very top too. The armory was originally built in resistance to the British and East Indian Company and to provide necessary weapons and ammunition to the soldiers who secured the fortress of Srirangapatna against them. Tipu's death place. In fourth and final colonial Mysore War, the British soldiers breached the city walls via water and Srirangapatna was seized. Tipu Sultan fought valiantly against the East Indian Company and was martyred in the fight. Body of Tipu was found here under the heap of dead bodies. A memory was erected by Colonel Wellesley at this spot in the form of a stone tablet. Bailey's Dungeon. Situated to the north of Ranganatha Swami Temple and close to Lal Mahal. The prisoners is a walled dungeon of length 30 meters and width 12 meters. Prisoners were chained to stone slabs in the walls and tortured. This prison is named after Captain or Colonel Bailey, who died here in 1792. Tipu Sultan used to imprison the British in this jail. and it is believed that the river water was let in to drown them as punishment. Lal Mahal or Tipu's Palace. The remains of the Tipu's Palace, also known as Lal Mahal, can be seen on the east of Ranganatha Swami Temple. The palace was very well known for its art, and it is vividly described and documented in the travel diaries of several French and British guests and travelers during 1800s. The palace boasts of vast Darbar Hall, Queen Quarters and a big courtyard. However, unfortunately, it was demolished in 1807-1809 on the order of Colonel Wellesley. Lakshmi Narasimha Temple. This temple was built in 17th century under the rule of Kantirava Narasimha Raja Vadayar, one of the great ruler of Mysore. It has a shrine with the main deity Sri Lakshmi Narasimha Swami. It is interesting to note that in 1826, the statue of Kantirava Narasimha Raja Vadayar was installed in a sub-shrine to the left of the Narasimha Swami temple. Wellesley Bridge cover the Kaveri at Srirangapatna was erected in 1804 under the direction of Diwan Purnaya at the cost of 5.5 lakhs and named after the Governor General, the Marquis of Wellesley. It is an interesting specimen of native architecture, being composed of stone pillars capped with stone corbel and surmounted by stone gardens. On which the flags of the roadway are lit. Though rough in construction, the bridge has survived the heaviest floods for a century without injury.